In this video, you'll learn about all the basics of customizing the ASP.NET MVC HTML Editor extension, starting from adding the extension into the project to diving deeper into an overview of its settings. Here I have a project with the home controller and index view with some HTML markup. Let's take a look at it in the browser. Here you can see that the content area only contains the text I just mentioned, so let's return to Visual Studio. To add the extension to my view, let's right-click at the position in the view where I want to insert the DevExpress HTML Editor extension. Then I'll select the Insert DevExpress MVC Extension item from the context menu, and the Insert Extension Wizard opens. In the Common tab, I select the HTML Editor. I leave the default extension name and its partial view name, leave all the options enabled, and click Insert. The Insert Extension Wizard generates all the necessary code for me. You can see that the view code has been changed, and in the output window, I can see what files have been changed or created. Let's look at the result in the browser. As you can see, the HTML editor appears. It's fully functional, and it displays several toolbars and an edit area. I can add some text here, see the text HTML code, and also see the preview of how it will be rendered in the browser. Next, I can return to Design View, change any text, and then see that the text HTML has been updated automatically. Let's return to Visual Studio and see what the wizard generated for me. In the Output window, I select the output from the DevExpress Extension Integrator. Here I see the view code has been modified by the wizard. It has inserted a link to the partial view. I can double-click the output item and navigate to the changed code. You can see that the actions and helpers have been added to the controller class. Here you can see that the wizard has already added the code that handles the HTML editor callback root values and image uploading. Let's take a look at the partial view code and the controller code at the same time, side by side. The callback root values are handled by the HTML editor partial action. The callback root values for the image uploading operation is handled by the corresponding action. The image selector settings are defined in the controller helper. This helper contains settings that define paths to the uploads and thumbnails folders, allowing file extensions, etc. Note that the wizard inserted all this code automatically, so I don't have to type this code manually. Let's take a look at the home controller code. The helper that contains the HTML editor settings defines the path to the image folders. Let's add the corresponding folders to make these paths valid. In order to have the ability to upload images, we need to place the HTML editor into the form. Let's do this with the using HTML.beginForm statement. Let's take a look at the possible HTML editor settings. I go to the view code and type settings. And Visual Studio IntelliSense shows all the available settings. I can define the extension's height, and the HTML property is a string that represents the HTML editor's content. The HTML editor provides you with several settings for items like the editor's forms, the image selector, loading panel, spell checker, and more. Let's modify the extension's width. To do this, I change the width property value to 700 pixels. And let's take a look at the result in the browser. I can click the Insert Image button and the Image Selector dialog appears. I open a new tab where I can find any image, copy its address, and return to the HTML editor. I paste the image URL and the image appears within the HTML editor. I can click the Insert Image button again and the Image Selector dialog appears. Now I choose image uploading from my local computer. I click Browse, select an image from my local file system, and click Select. The HTML editor now displays two images. You can see the HTML code or the preview. Let's close the browser and return to Visual Studio. Next, let's simplify the HTML editor layout. I delete the code for image uploading and add the code I prepared before. In this code, I add toolbars for selecting the font name and size. I also add several useful buttons. Let's take a look at the result in the browser. Here you can see that the HTML editor layout has been modified. Now I can select the required font name and size. I can also justify text to left, right, or center. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.